In lesson 4.4, students are introduced to the idea of covalent bonding. Now, students have already seen that atoms have a positive nucleus and negative electrons, but why would one atom bond to another? Let's see. They've seen this picture of a hydrogen atom before with its positive proton and negative electron, but why would this hydrogen atom bond with that hydrogen atom? Let's see. We're going to play this animation twice just so that we understand what's happening. When you saw the double-headed arrow, that indicates that there's an attraction between the proton from this hydrogen atom and the electron from this one. And the other double-headed arrow indicates there's an attraction between the proton from this hydrogen atom and the electron from this one. So there's a mutual and even attraction between the positive and negative parts of both atoms. So let's see. There's an attraction between these, an attraction between these, and they bring them together. Now, the electrons are near two protons, which is even better for them. It's considered to be what we call a lower energy level. They're sort of more stable now when they're bonded than they were before. So let's keep going. So you can show students in detail what happens in that simulation by using pictures that are in the lesson. You can see that the two hydrogen atoms are near each other, that their mutual attraction of the proton from one and the electron from the other bring them together, and then when they bond, they're more stable now that they're bonded than when they were separated. And on the activity sheet, students put captions beneath these drawings so that they can review what they've seen in the simulation and what you've been teaching. So does the same thing happen in water or something similar? Well, in this case, we show the two hydrogens in water because hydrogen is H2O. So two hydrogens and an oxygen. And it makes sense that these should be drawn the way they are because oxygen has two electrons on the first energy level and six on the second. So let's see what happens. And we'll just play that again real quick. So there's a mutual attraction between the protons and electrons of the oxygen and hydrogen here, and the same thing for this hydrogen and the oxygen. So they come together and bond. And now these electrons are near more protons, and it's a more stable arrangement than it was when they were unbonded. So this is what we say, it's at a lower energy level. This is a good place for all the atoms to be. And if you counted up the electrons, you'd see that in the outer energy level of oxygen, there's 8. And in the outer energy level for hydrogen, there's 2. So the outer energy levels are filled and they're in a more stable position than they were before. And we do the same thing on the student activity sheet where students write captions or descriptions of what's happening during this process. There's a cool little activity where if you take two pencils and you sharpen them at both ends and put a battery, that's a little transistor radio kind of battery, in between and hook it up like it's shown here, you can cause the oxygen and the hydrogen to come out of the water. What we tried to show here is that there's more bubbles on one pencil than the other because there's twice as much hydrogen as oxygen because it's H2. So that hydrogen gas, there's twice as much. Also, if you want to, you can show students that there's something called a double covalent bond. When oxygen bonds with another oxygen atom, it makes O2, and it's not just one electron from each atom that's shared, but two. In this case, these two electrons are attracted from this nucleus, and these two electrons are attracted by that nucleus, and it brings the oxygens together, and again, there's 8 electrons in the outer electron level of each oxygen atom. And students describe this process on the activity sheet. Now, if you're in an NGSS state, there's a performance expectation, MSPS 1.1, which says, develop models to describe the atomic composition of simple molecules and extended structures. Well, in lesson 4.4, students are using models of covalent bonding to show how atoms come together and form simple molecules. they formed H2, H2O, and O2. Although the NGSS middle school standards don't specifically include content on the parts of the atom, the periodic table, or covalent or ionic bonding, your state or district may include aspects of these concepts to help students develop a deeper understanding of the atomic composition of molecules. In the foundation boxes, science and engineering practices is about developing a model to predict or describe phenomena. Well, in this case, students are developing a model to describe covalent bonding. For disciplinary core ideas, substances are made from different types of atoms, and each pure substance has characteristic physical and chemical properties. In this case, we're showing that atoms come together through covalent bonding to form molecules, and they do it by sharing electrons because of mutual attractions. For scale, proportion, and quantity, the idea of looking at the protons and electrons in order to understand the process of covalent bonding is looking at a very small scale in order to understand how the molecule is made. So good luck with the lesson, and thanks for watching.